my big 2016 prediction, I think, is going to be fairly obvious. Star Wars, Star Wars, Star Wars. And I think the popularity of Star Wars is just going to grow over the next year. We're going to get a movie every single year, and I've got hopes that pretty much every single one of them is going to be awesome. So I'm really excited that this is basically never-ending Star Wars starting right now.
What I think is going to be big in 2016 is the new Deadpool film, because, you know, Ryan Reynolds. I think Deadpool is a super fun character, doesn't take himself too seriously, and it's a rated R superhero movie, so it's going to be a lot of action, a lot of inappropriate content, and it's going to be a good time.
What I think is going to be huge in 2016, probably Fantastic Beasts and Where to Find Them, the new movie set in the Wizarding World of Harry Potter. It's going to be the first screenplay from writer J.K. Rowling. The fact that she's creating a whole new set of stories and canon for Harry Potter fans is really exciting. So I'm very much looking forward to that. So is my kid, and I'm sure a lot of Harry Potter fans out there.
There's a chance that we'll be seeing for the first time The Stand, or possibly The Dark Tower, or possibly It. Three major Stephen King projects on the big screen. If even one of those makes it, I think it's going to be a big deal and represent another check mark in the pop culture canon.
I think one of the biggest games that will be coming out next year is Dishonored 2. The folks at Arkham made a really awesome stealth game, probably one of the best stealth games of the past decade with the first Dishonored. Finally, the Dishonored 2 will be coming out later this year, and I'm really looking forward to it.
My fan moment prediction for 2016 is that this will be the year Nintendo finally reveals details about the NX, and it will be the story of the show at E3. My dream scenario is they will actually announce that it comes out this holiday, 2016.
I'm gonna actually pick Captain America Civil War, and I'll tell you why. That movie is almost in and of its own right a pseudo Avengers sequel. It's going to be jam-packed with some of the characters that we've kind of grown to love through the Avengers films, but it also is going to introduce some new characters. We're going to finally get to see Black Panther up on the big screen. That's going to be really exciting, and we're going to get to see the Marvel Studios version of Spider-Man up on the big screen.